Good morning, students. Once again, I welcome you to my video lectures on signals and systems. And in the last class, the first chapter in any standard textbook, first chapter is devoted to operations on signals and system properties. So I completed chapter one, and in chapter two. This chapter 2 goes by the name LTI systems. LTI. L stands for linearity. TI stands for time invariant. LTI systems. Systems possessing linearity property and time invariant properties. So here, that is what LTI system. In any standard textbook, second chapter is on LTI systems. So in this LTI system, that is linear time invariant system, I have shown a block diagram. This is nothing but block diagram. Here HT, input signal, or XN in the case of discrete signal. This is LTI system. On the output side, if the signal is input, then we are going to get a continuous time output. YT. If the signal is discrete in nature, then output is YN. And as you know, this is the mathematical notation. Y of T is equal to transformation on XT, or Y of N equal to transformation on XN. Now the question arises, under this chapter, what all we are going to study? See, we used to Now, what we are going to study in this chapter? See, in this chapter, first, we have to relate output to input. We have to relate output to input in some manner. That is the first question. In how many ways can we relate the output of an LTI system to the input of an LTI system? That is the question. There are four basic methods of relating output with input. I will write one by one. The first method is what is known as impulse response method. Impulse response method. This is the method, first method. So under this heading, impulse response method, you come across what is known as convolution. Convolution between continuous time signals or convolution between discrete time signals. This is what is known as impulse response method. Now I will give example. Y of t is equal to x of t convolving with h of t, or y of n is equal to x of n convolving with h of n. So this is the notation. Y of t is equal to x of t. This symbol stands for convolution. Convolution between aperiodic signals. That means signals that are not periodic. So this is the notation used for convolution. And HT is what is called as impulse response. What is known as impulse response. When I take up convolution, I will explain what is impulse response. Nothing to worry now. Either HT or HN is what is known as impulse response. And this is the notation used for convolution. This is what is called as impulse response method. And under this method, you work out convolution, and it requires imagination. Okay, while solving problems on impulse response method, that is using convolution, so you require what is known as imagination. One waveform will be stationary, another waveform will be moving, and there will be overlapping. Okay, and it is very interesting to study convolution, and I will take up at a later and next stage. Next is, this is first method. Second method is what is known as second method of relating output with input. Second method is what is known as, if the signals are continuous time, it is what is known as differential equations. Differential equations. So through differential equations, or in the case of continuous time signals, it is differential equations, or in the case of discrete time signals, it is called as difference equation. Difference equations. So we used to relate output with input through differential equations or difference equations. I will show you an example for differential equation. D square y by dt square plus 3dy by dt plus 3dy by dt plus y is equal to x of t. Equal to x of t. One side you will find derivatives of output, on the other side you find derivatives of the input. Maybe a derivative may be there, dx by dt. This is what is called as second order linear differential equation. So d square y by dt square plus 3dy by dt plus y. So this is what is known as differential equation. Differential equation. We have to solve this differential equation. You can easily score marks on this. Okay. So score, you can, a good opportunity for students to score marks on this topic. This is what is known as solving differential equations. This is second method. Now, if the signals are continuous time, then we have what is known as difference equation. Difference equation here, y of n minus 2y of n minus 1 is equal to 2x of n. An example. I have given an example. This is what is known as difference equation. Difference equation. On one side, like differential equation, on one side you will find output and it shifts. And it shifts. See, y of n means output. Y of n minus 1 means shift of one unit for output. And on this side, simply we have xn. One side output and it shifts. On the other side, input and it shifts. This is what is known as difference equation. We have to solve this difference equation for y of n. And it's a scoring opportunity for students. Okay. Difference equation solving. This is second method. Third method is what is known as block diagram approach. Block diagram approach. Third one is what is known as block diagram approach. Any subject you take, students will have a better understanding when we understand through what are known as block diagrams. So here in signals and systems also we have block diagram approach between input and output. So block diagram approach is third method. I will give example. First I will consider continuous time. And on the other side I will consider discrete time, and this is also as a scoring opportunity for students. So block diagrams, you come across what are known as direct form 1, direct form 2. Very interesting and easily you can score marks on continuous time as well as discrete time block diagram approach. Now I will give example for continuous time. So for continuous time, this is the block diagram. This is the simple block diagram we shall have. X of t, this is what is called as summer. This is what is called as integrator. This is y of t. And this is 2. Now this is what is called as block diagram. In block diagrams we have blocks. This block is called as integrator block. Integrator, any block that performs integration, that is called as integrator block. And this is a constant value 2. Okay, and no significance for this. So just it multiplies the signal by 2. Okay, whatever the input signal comes, it is get multiplied by 2. That's all. Okay, so this is what is called as block diagram for continuous time. Now you have to solve problem on this. Very interesting. This is yt. Now I will sketch one more diagram, block diagram, that is for discrete time systems. So for discrete time system, this is the typical block diagram. X of n, here we have S1, then a summer, then here we have a block, then another block, two, then this is y of n. So in this block diagram you will find ingredients like this. This is what is called as summer. This is also another summer. Summer means it adds signals. Okay, and you find S blocks means stands for shift. S stands for shift block. That means S to the power of 1 means it produces a shift of 1 unit on this input signal. This is what is called as block diagram. We have to solve this block diagram. This is what is called as third method. Last one, that is not in your syllabus. It is not in your syllabus. Higher semester students will study under this heading, what is known as advanced control systems. In advanced control system, they are in classical control system, they study what are known as state variable method. So it is a matrix notation. We used to write in matrix notation x dot equal to ax plus bu, then y equal to cx plus du. Nothing to worry for you, because this is not in your syllabus. State variable method in matrix notation, x dot equal to ax plus bu, y equal to cx plus du. This is not in your syllabus. Okay, and you need not have to worry about this. So concentrate only on the first 3 methods. So in the next class, I will take up the convolution. First, I will take up convolution of discrete signals, and then after gaining experience, we go to what convolution between continuous time signals. Thank you.